chiefs of Philippine National Police doubling down on its efforts to track down the suspects behind the killing of the police chief of San Miguel, Bulacan, or San Miguel Town in Bulacan. PNP spokesperson Jean Fajardo says the manhunt operation has been widened to the whole of Central Luzon region. Police Lieutenant Colonel Marlon Serna was killed in an encounter with supposed robbers Saturday night. Police have already released a sketch of one of the two perpetrators. A total of 1.2 million pesos has been offered as a reward for anyone who can provide information on the suspects.
Sa ngayon nga po, may mga tinututukan na pong lead ang PNP at umaasa nga po tayo sa tulong ang ating mga kababayan at paglabas nga po natin itong sketch po ay matutunton at makikilala na po natin itong mga suspects. Gagawin po lahat ng PNP ang magagawa para mahuli po itong suspect na ito at lahat suspects na ito at lahat po ng assistance ay ibinibigay po natin sa pamilya.
President Marcos leads the inauguration for the first section of the North Luzon Expressway Connector Project. Our very own Katrina Domingo joining us live now with an update. Kat, over to you.
Hi, Carmina. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. urged private contractors to deliver their projects with the government on time, noting that the synergy between the public and private sectors is a defining factor in the overall development of the country. He said that during a speech delivered during the inauguration of the North Luzon Expressway Connectors Phase 1. Here's a portion of the president's speech.
I call upon the DOTR and the NLEX Corporation to work closely and effectively in accomplishing our noble objectives in improving the road infrastructure on this side of the country. Try very hard, as we all do, to stay within the target time frame. Although your success rate in this regard is exemplary, avoid unnecessarily delays and finish the project as scheduled so that the Filipino people will be able to reap the benefits as soon as possible.
Carmina, the president adds that developing and constructing high-impact infrastructure projects that are visible and directly felt by the people will be the credible proof that the government is working for the public. The president also congratulated the NLEX Corporation for delivering the first phase of the NLEX connector, which is expected to cut traffic between Manila and Caloocan to 5 minutes, and underscored that this is only one of many efforts to ease congestion in the metro. He also urged private firms to continue their service to the public with integrity, accountability, and professionalism. Carmina.
Thanks a lot. Katrina Domingo there, joining us live. Another reprieve for motorists as oil prices are set to go down for the second week in a row. Kerosene prices will take the biggest cut of 1 peso and 90 centavos per liter. A liter of diesel will be 1 peso and 30 centavos cheaper. Gasoline will have the smallest drop of 85 centavos per liter. Analysts attributed the expected decline to the closure of some banks in the U.S. and Switzerland, which lessens demand for oil. The country's power grid operator warning of power interruptions this summer season. That's after the Energy Regulatory Commission denied the request of the National Grid Corporation of the Philippines for a monthly extension on its ancillary services agreements while bids are being evaluated. Ancillary services help the NGCP manage power fluctuations and maintain a reliable power system. The NGCP now says that denial makes the country's transmission grid vulnerable to power outages. It adds many of the NGCP's ancillary agreements have expired, and it will take months for a new deal to be approved.